I'm Deborah Garlick from henpicked.net and Henpicked Menopause in the Workplace, and today I'm here to talk to you about menopause. Absolutely clueless. I had no idea what was going on. I had no idea what menopause was all about and what the signs and symptoms of menopause were. So when I started to experience excruciating pain, I was actually very worried that there was something seriously wrong with me. And I did find myself in hospital twice. The first time was with suspected appendicitis. The second was a suspected heart attack. And of course, it was nothing to do with any other ailment. I was fit and healthy. It was actually the menopause that was causing those symptoms. I think that probably depends on who you ask. If you asked me at the time, I would have told you about the physical symptoms, the pain, the palpitations. But after about a year of experiencing those sort of problems, my husband called time and said we needed to get some specialist help. And halfway through the appointment, my husband put his hand on the table and said, "She's a nightmare to live with. It's awful." I was really shocked about that. I thought I was managing everything really well. But if I look at an average month for me, I would spend a month with crashing fatigue, just about managing to get through the day. I'd spend the weekend in bed. And then for the other 3 weeks of the month, I'd spend time catching up with everything that I'd missed. And so the psychological symptoms for me were probably the worst. It was the anxiety and the worry, and that continually escalated. I think probably by the end of the first year, I got to a stage where my confidence was absolutely on the carpet. Yes, the menopause. I wasn't expecting it at all, and I find this a lot when I speak to women. What we don't realise are the range of symptoms that you can experience during the menopause transition. Everything from the physical symptoms, sleeplessness, lack of energy, fatigue, all of those physical symptoms, aches and pains, joint aches, I could go on, changes in your skin, so many symptoms from a physical point of view. But actually, the psychological symptoms are the ones that many women say affect them most and are possibly the earliest signs of menopause. So anxiety and worry, lacking in confidence, memory, recall. I have notebooks, I'm a listaholic. And those psychological symptoms are just so unknown. It's really not just about hot flushes. Everybody associates hot flushes, and I meet so many women who say, "It can't be the menopause, I've never had a hot flush." Well, I'm 10 years in now, into my menopause transition. I've never had a hot flush. I'm always cold. I think I would go with no, you're not on your own. I hear from a lot of women that have never talked to anybody about their menopause. And when you consider that 3 in 4 women will experience menopausal symptoms and 1 in 4 could experience serious symptoms, why do we keep it to ourselves? You're not on your own. Do talk to somebody about menopausal symptoms if they're getting in the way of your life. Don't struggle in silence. I wish I'd have been told the whole story. We all have hormones in our bodies from the day we're born to the day we die. And for women, we have some significant changes that go on during that time. We have puberty, we then have our monthly cycles, and we have maternity. And of course, during maternity, there's lots of support. Everybody wants to share their story with you. You've got all of the support that you need. So why are we missing out on menopause? Don't get me wrong, we are making progress. We are talking about it more. But until we normalise the conversation and make sure the right support's in place, I'm sure many, many women will continue to experience what I experienced. The thing that I'll point out first is my HRT. I've been taking HRT for 8 years. It works really well for me. And I mention it because I talk to a lot of women who say things like, I tried HRT for a fortnight and it didn't work for me. And I get that. We're all different. We'll all work out how to manage our symptoms ourselves. But when people talk about HRT, they tend to lump them all together as if they're one product, in the same way perhaps that we do the birth control pill. That's not actually the case. There's a whole range of HRT products. So you can tailor them and get the right prescription or right combination for you. So I've always got mine with me. I work away a lot, so I generally keep it in my handbag, although I'm not usually asked to get it out. And the next thing I've pulled out of my handbag are my HIIT gloves. It was a little bit of a relief to find these because at first I thought I was pulling out a pair of knickers out of my handbag. These are the gloves I wear at the gym at HIIT classes, or I'll do a Meno Health class. It's about keeping fit and about thinking about your long-term health, whether that's your heart health or your bone health. You know, I always worry about the risk of osteoporosis. It's an important thing to think about. And getting hot and sweaty and keeping moving can really help with that. And I appreciate it's not always something a menopausal woman wants to do. You know, if you're feeling tired or you have low energy or you're just not feeling great, your mood's not there, you don't always want to go and exercise. But actually, whichever form of exercise you choose, whether it's going for a long walk or whatever, just keep moving. Next thing in my handbag are my supplements. These ones are omega-3s. Lifestyle, diet, is incredibly important during and post-menopause to make sure we're getting all of the right nutrients. I'm not just thinking here of symptoms, I'm thinking of longer-term health in particular. We're all supposed to be taking vitamin D, whether you're menopausal or not. We don't get enough sunshine in the UK. But also things like magnesium and calcium for healthy bones. We know the risk of bone and heart health post-menopause, and it's absolutely the time that we should all be taking stock and thinking about what do I want the rest of my life to be? How healthy am I going to be for the rest of my life? And the next thing in my handbag, hand cream. Yeah, I do need to moisturise a lot. Your skin does change as you go through menopause and beyond. It does become drier. But one of the symptoms that I had, which I've not mentioned before, is I had acne for 7 years. And you know, a lot of people don't realise that acne can be a symptom of menopause. And for me in particular, I had to have Roaccutane for a year. To clear all of the acne out of my system. So I don't really know if it's the menopause that's made my skin drier than it was before, or whether it was the acne treatment which pretty much drained all of the oils from my body. But nevertheless, I've always got hand creams, all five of them, on me at any particular time. And last but not least, I have vaginal dryness cream in my handbag. Now, it's not something I struggle with as much as some women say, but then there's a lot that you can do for vaginal dryness. I take HRT, and there's also local estrogen creams that can make the world of difference. But actually, an intimate moisturiser, shall we say, and this is one that is actually available from Boots, is just there for moments of, let's say, a little bit of extra discomfort. And what I don't have in my handbag are tampons. I'm post-menopause, I haven't had to think about tampons for a few years now, and I can wear my white jeans with confidence. Advice on sex. This is the point where my daughter has just turned the video off. A change in somebody's sex drive, whether that's up or down, and potentially vaginal dryness can be a symptom of menopause. But that doesn't mean to say that your sex life is over. There is something that women can do about that to manage those symptoms, whether that's HRT, whether that's a local estrogen, whether that's moisturisers. So don't think sex is off the menu. It doesn't have to be. It's also worth thinking about what's going on in our minds, in our relationships. You know, maybe we're all different on this, aren't we? I mean, I'm sure some people may still be swinging from the chandeliers with their sex life. And then others are happy in their relationship with holding hands and a cup of tea. It's a personal choice. If you've got a really busy day and you're feeling tired, maybe you've still got children at home, you might have caring responsibilities. You might not feel like sex at that time. Your libido would probably be ranking pretty low. But if George Clooney walked through that door with a premium coffee and a nice smile on his face, or Keira Knightley, or personally for me, it would be Tom Hardy, where would your libido be at that moment? Probably up here. So maybe it's more about us giving ourselves some space and time and going back to those romantic times, making sure you're wearing matching underwear or a visit to a local sex shop, maybe. So there's a lot you can do about it. Sex is not off the menu.